Hey, how's it going, guys? This is Dave2D, and welcome to episode 7 of My Laptop Setup, a series where I feature the laptop setups that you guys submit to me and then showcase whatever it is that you do with your gear. And this week's episode is on web developers, so people who design and create websites. So first up, we have a submission from Eggman. He's a university student who works on creative stuff with his free time. The main piece of his setup is the Dell XPS 15 9550. It's the same laptop that I use most frequently. So his is loaded up a little differently. He's got 32 gigs of RAM and he's got the Core i5. He protects his laptop with an Inotech sleeve, and I think Inotech makes some of the best valued sleeves and laptop cases on Amazon. He uses a Mad Catz Rat 3 gaming mouse and a SteelSeries quick pad. For audio, he uses the Sennheiser Urbanite on ear and a JBL Go wireless Bluetooth speaker. He also has a Globe Bantam cruiser skateboard in a pretty awesome color. And so he carries all of this stuff using a Nike Embarca backpack. And this has a strap up front to hold his skateboard. So Eggman plays games and he also develops a website for a friend called foodcreating.com. And it's not live yet, but it looks like it's a food blog for sharing recipes and other food ideas and stuff. And the cool thing about this is that he learned to develop this website by himself. Like, he didn't go to school for it. He didn't do anything that was kind of related to web development. He just kind of decided to pick it up and learn it. And that's pretty cool. He plans on having both German and English versions. And I'll definitely check this site out when it goes live. Thanks for your submission, man. Okay, next up we have a submission from Xing, or Xing, a university student from Singapore. He says that most of his coursework at school is built around web development for both front and back end. And he actually built this particular website as his submission. He obviously has some skills. It's pretty cool. So I'm actually just gonna use Shadowplay on his website to kind of show you what I'm looking at. So first we have his Noling shot, so we can see his setup. And this over here looks like he's flexing his HTML skills in a program called Atom. He actually uses other programs as well to do website development. His laptop is a Dell E5440. It's running an NVIDIA GT720M and it's been upgraded with an SSD. There's some pics of it. The mouse he uses is the Logitech G502. It's a really, really good sensor. I like this one. He also has this laptop cooler that I've never seen before. It's called an O-Polar, and it looks like it works by sucking the hot air out of your laptop instead of blowing cool air around it or underneath it like a lot of traditional cooling pads work. And it's small, or at least it looks really small, so I'm definitely gonna try one of these out. That's really neat. He's using an LG G3, a Pebble Time smartwatch, a SanDisk flash drive, and a pair of Audio Technica earphones. He also has this micro USB cable, but they've designed the tip so that it's reversible. So these are really cool. They're cheap and they make charging device at night a lot easier because you don't have to worry about which side of your cable is facing up. So I'll link the one that I've used before in the video description. Okay, last up we have a submission from XH208. I assume that's not his real name. He's from London. His setup is pretty minimal. He's using a 15-inch MacBook Pro from 2010. It's an older machine, but I really loved how easy that generation of MacBook was for upgrades and repairs. He has a OnePlus 3, a solid phone. I wish I'd done a review on that, but I didn't have time. He's got an Amazon Kindle and an external drive from Western Digital. So he submitted a pretty cool website that he developed with his friend called domcomp.com. It's basically a domain comparison site. And I don't look up domains very often. I mean, I've only done this a handful of times when I needed a specific URL. But this site, domcomp.com, it lets you search availability, obviously, but the big draw is pricing. Like, it compares the pricing of a particular URL amongst the different providers so that you can shop around for the best price. And that's pretty cool. So that wraps up this week's episode. If you're interested in submitting your own stuff, check the video description below. There's full instructions on how to submit your own stuff there, and there will be prizes. I'm sorry it's taken so long for me to kind of come up with the video, but I will be doing a dedicated video that kind of explains how the whole process works. I'm gonna try to do it for next week or the week after that. If you have submitted and you haven't seen your particular content in a particular episode that was related to your content, don't worry, there will be future episodes that have the same kind of theme to it. So if you didn't see your stuff in the gamer episode, there will be future gamer episodes as well. Hope you guys enjoyed this one. Thumbs if you liked it, subs if you loved it. It's been nice. I'll see you guys next time.